Evolution is a wonderful thing. And you can see that with the Toyota Innova. It started out as the very popular Tamarau before turning into the FX, the Revo, which has evolved into something like this.
Wow, that's a really sexy voice, dude.
Thank you.
Vince here, and I'm joining Eric on this one, and we'll take a look at the new Toyota Innova. This time, we'll double team it.
Tandem. You all know what the Toyota Innova is, but what's more important is the significance of this model. Number one, maybe, is that it's made in my hometown, Santa Rosa, Laguna.
But wait, you just moved here, right? But nevertheless, another important thing about the Innova is that it's what we call a last survivor because it evolved to outlive and outplay and outwit many of its competitors.
The winner of Survivor.
In the category, I mean, the Adventure is gone, the Crosswind is gone, even the Fusion is already gone, even though there's one over there and with that neighbor's house. But either way, they really leveled it up with the Innova. I mean, Eric, what do you think of this model?
Well, definitely the most stylish Innova yet.
Well, it's not really the Innova was never really what we call a style beacon in the first place, but it's good that Toyota really leveled it up with more LEDs mm-hmm. all around, more chrome. I know Tito's like, you love your
like
chrome.
Like it's shiny.
Toyota added a few nice bits and pieces to take the Innova into the new decade. The secret to the Innova's longevity is really right here. The frame is still more like an AUV, more like a truck, a pickup, but it has the body of a more modern MPV. That is what Toyota brought together with the Innova. The other thing is the engine. Many people still look for diesel power, and that's what Toyota delivered. This one has 174 horsepower and 360 newton meters of torque down low because, again, it's a diesel. It also has a 6-speed automatic driving the rear wheels. Now, normally, if in the older generation of diesels, we won't be able to talk to you with the hood open because it would be too noisy. But because this is very modern and it has a lot of the improvements made to the new generation diesel engines, particularly with CRDI, I can talk to you without raising my voice while Eric is inside enjoying the aircon.
From here, you can see why the Toyota Innova is extremely popular. I mean, it's just so functional. You can split, tumble, fold the seats however you want it, just to accommodate the cargo you're putting in. If there's one thing about the Innova, though, it's these fold-up seats. They may not be as hard with the Innova compared to the Fortuner because this sits lower to the ground, but it's 2021. I mean, Toyota can definitely do better, right?
Yeah, the Innova has really endured in the class because number one, it's diesel powered, and two, it's offering a lot of creature comforts for the price that previously you wouldn't have seen in this category. I mean, now, especially with the second generation Innova, a lot of things have improved, like the interior, the seats, the materials they used. The first generation Innovas, they were more utilitarian. Yes, Toyota tried to spice it up with some car with a wood trim here and there, and they still have that in this vehicle, but it's definitely leveled up compared to before. Now, there are many reasons why the Innova is still popular, and it really comes down to the way Toyota blended the ruggedness of an AUV with the comfort and the functionality of an MPV. And you can see that here, especially in the second generation model. It actually really does feel nice. The appointments look very premium. That gauge cluster is very nice. Center stack is nice and neat. Cup holder here, very functional there. It even has a cool box on the upper glove compartment. So if you put drinks there, it'll cool it down. So those are the things we like about the Innova so far. The throttle response of the Innova isn't fantastic, but that's expected anyway. This is still a diesel, so meaning it likes to stay down low in the RPM range. But you do have quite a good deal of torque from 1200 RPM already. And acceleration is actually all right. Even when it's fully loaded, well, right now we only have Eric there in the back. But when it comes to fuel economy, that's what's impressive about the Innova, because again, being a diesel and being that the torque is plenty down low and it has a 6-speed auto, you can cruise at a very low RPM at a good speed. So don't be surprised if you're getting good fuel economy numbers out of your Innova. Yes, there are some things I think Toyota can improve on with the Innova, but the one thing I really want them to focus on is adding USB ports, because looking around the vehicle, none. You do have one for the head unit, but that's it. There's a 12-volt outlet in front and one in the back, but no USB ports anywhere else. I mean, there, Eric, in the back?
None.
So yeah, so next time, maybe Toyota should put in more USB ports, because that's kind of a necessity in a vehicle like this. Now to you, Eric.
Well, thank you, Vince. As you can see, I'm very comfortable here. And there's a lot of space for me. And the seats in front aren't even all the way forward yet, but I have a lot of wiggle room and I can recline the backrest to make it more relaxing. I'm doing that while I'm still wearing my seatbelt. I also love the overhead console. It's very easy to operate, to reach, to change the fan speed. There's a tray table here that I can use. The armrests are very comfortable. No USB ports, unfortunately, but you can make do with, you know, one of those things that you plug in for USB ports. I wish they had leather seats though. Be, you know, a lot more luxurious. There isn't much legroom left if I push the captain seats all the way back. So that's what I wish for as well. A little bit more legroom in the third row. But other than that, I love it in the second row of the Innova. Driver, Manong Vince, dito na lang.
What do you think of the drive and the ride?
Vince, number one, from the second row, I love the captain seats with the armrests. You can relax and enjoy the drive. I mean, literally. There's so much space in front because you can move the seats forward, backwards, and, you know, just have fun during the drive. I also love that it has those tray tables that fold up and down from the backrest of the front seat.
Very airline
because,
style.
It's easy to put, if you have eats, if you're bringing like food, drinks and whatnot, you can enjoy them while you're riding and driving. Also the overhead airline style console. You can adjust the air vents very easily because it's within reach. And then, you know, it's just the overall feel of being in the second row, being on captain seats. It's different.
The best seats in the house. I mean,
obviously.
What can you expect?
if I may, I would love to have some maybe a sunroof right there, and some monitors for you know.
Oh, no monitors?
Occupants really? Of the second row, because at 1.7 million, a little more than that, let's be honest, expectations are very high.
Yeah, because I mean, they're at that category, there are many competitors already, but even so far, the Innova is holding its own.
Yeah.
Because, well, it's got diesel power and torque. I still like
that's
that.
That's one of its best features,
definitely,
obviously.
Yeah. I mean, the quality inside has definitely improved compared to the previous generation and even the pre-facelift model.
Sure.
The only thing I really want Toyota to work on here is put a few more things that actually matter. Like, for example, this one doesn't have cruise control.
I was surprised.
I mean, normally in a top spec vehicle, you have that already at this price.
Even for an MPV?
Yeah, even for an MPV. And also, the steering. I think the steering, it's a common trait amongst Innovas to not have the steering wheel so straight.
It's off-center?
Yeah, off-center. And even the mileage of this is very low. It's like 1,600. So for that, it's like, why is it already off-center? But nevertheless, the Innova is still going to be popular. But there are definitely more competitors in the category.
Who are there?
Well, I think the best one to compare this to would be the Okavango. And next time, you know what? Let's double team it.
Tandem?
Double team? Tandem? Anyways, this is Vince of Auto Industria and...
I'm Eric.
And thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe with this video and to our channel. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And we'll see you on the next one when we tandem another couple of vehicles.
Double team.
Double team.
Tandem.
Right.